In modern times, good quality television is still very hard to find. If you haven't seen the previous video before this featuring my rant on the Disney Channel, then I suggest that you go and see it before you view this video. But if you already have, sit back and relax as today I take on one of the three great evil networks of modern times, Nickelodeon. The storm has come again, and this time, I'm not holding back. Nickelodeon, for a long time, has billed itself as the first kids' network. Well, I don't know about all that, because Disney was making programming for kids as early as 1940. Well, the problem with Disney Channel is the fact that they've replaced what was once good programming with bad. Nickelodeon seems to have a different problem, and that problem is the fact that they cancel good shows before they can ever have a good run. If you were born in the mid-90s or became a television fan around then you probably remember that we had really good shows back when we were young. There was Rocko's Modern Life, Ah Real Monsters, Hey Arnold, and a lot of others that we still remember. And not only that, but Nickelodeon didn't just have cartoons. It had a lot of great live-action shows that still managed to appeal to kids. But what happened to them? I'll tell you what happened. Nickelodeon canceled them. Why? You tell me. You see, Nickelodeon never gave a good reason for canceling any show that they ever took off the air. Not long ago on Nickelodeon, there was a great show called All That. It was a sketch comedy show following similar shows at the time like Saturday Night Live, except the humor was geared toward kids. Surprisingly, this worked. And All That managed to stay on the run with a different cast basically every year. But after the 10th season, it pretty much faded into nothingness. Why? I mean, come on, we like this show. Keep showing it. I mean, it seems like a no-brainer, but apparently the Nickelodeon Studios executives really don't have any brains. Come on. If a show is getting good ratings, it doesn't take a genius to know that if you leave it on there, kids will watch your network. Anyway, later shows would go on to follow this formula, like The Amanda Show. Although, it didn't exactly live up to the original All That, The Amanda Show still was a pretty good show in its time. And even when they were still showing reruns, I liked it because it gave me a sense of nostalgia. We also had great cartoons and even great game shows. Not game shows like The Price is Right, no. Game shows that would appeal to kids. How did they do this, you ask? With amazing physical challenges. Everyone remembers this who subscribes, these channels who subscribes to Nick Gas or Games and Sports. I still think that was a stupid name. Anyway, we had Legends of the Hidden Temple. That was one of my favorites. It was a great show. It basically pit a whole bunch of kids in different colored outfits for different teams, giving them cool names like the Blue Barracudas. There was always a challenge at the end where they'd go through the shrine of a silver monkey. And I especially loved the talking statue head. That was a great twist. And then there was Double Dare 2000. Now, this was probably the most embarrassing out of them all. Come on. When you had to fish for a tiny flag in a giant peanut butter and jelly sandwich, you know that this game show is unlike any other. And not only that, but they had Mark Summers as the host. Where is he now? Hosting Unwrapped. That's still one of my favorite shows on Food Network. I love Food Network, can't you tell? But just like all the other good shows on Nickelodeon, it was fucking canceled! I don't know what their problem is. I mean, the fact that... I can understand the fact that shows like Zoe 101 got canceled because Jamie Lynn got knocked up. Serves her right, if you ask me. But the fact of the matter is, if you have a good show on your network, why cancel it? It makes no fucking sense. Okay, now let's get back to the cartoons. Back when I first started becoming a fan of television, we had cartoons like Rugrats, Hey Arnold, and even the Ren and Stimpy show used to be on Nick. I mean, my mom practically had a heart attack when she first saw me watching Ren and Stimpy. I mean, but I wonder what her reaction would be if she saw some of the anime that I watch now. Then again, I don't want to know. Anyway, I can understand why that show got canceled. Parents obviously thought that the humor was too crude for their kids to watch. It was funny! I mean, why do we care? Stupid soccer moms, they ruin everything. But how could you take a show off the air that was about babies? Rugrats managed to run for about... I'd say about 200 episodes, to be honest. Yeah, it was that good. I mean, a show about babies, you wouldn't think that it would be interesting. But the fact that most of the show existed in the kids' imaginations was really what brought the story to life. And I'd also like to give a shout-out to one of my favorites, which was Chalk Zone. Now, this show really was a show where anything could happen. It all depended on what the creator thinks of. And it's small wonder that the Chalk Zone fanfic section on the Nickelodeon message boards, yes, Nickelodeon has message boards. Who'd have thought it? And there's the Chalk Zone fanfic section on the message boards is really huge. Chalk Zone allows for pretty much anything to happen, and that's why we loved it. But why? Why, Nickelodeon, do you keep trying out new experiments that won't work? I mean, come on. First you try to make a sitcom that was targeted toward kids. Then you take off all the good shows and see what we'll like next. Then you take shows from Nicktoons Network and air them for, like, one day, and then never show them again, just to tease people into buying the Nicktoons Network for their TV, so they'll make money. So you'll make money off of us. Holy crap! That's exactly why it sucks. Nickelodeon wants us to buy Nicktoons. That's why they keep taking good shows off the air. That's why, because they always go to the Nicktoons Network. And besides that, they think that just like Disney, that kids are dumb enough to buy anything. I mean, buy anything. I mean, they're dumb enough to watch or accept anything that comes on TV. So instead, they just air crap and expect the people who have the only that the and they've come to expect that the only people who are true fans of them are the ones that watch the programming that they actually had a long time ago, which they actually put out effort for, and instead cause them to buy Nicktoons Network, where they actually focus most of their creative projects toward. And another thing, what the fuck is up with Jimmy Neutron and all these stupid movies? It seems like everywhere you turn, there's a 1 hour long episode of Jimmy Neutron, and they call it a movie. Not only that, but some stupid game company will undoubtedly release a video game for it. But before I close this video, I'd also like to say one more thing. Nickelodeon, Danny Phantom was the greatest thing to ever happen to you. And what did you do? You took it off the fucking air. Nickelodeon, I have no more words for you except die!